Hi, my name is Denis Lunev. I will talk today about taking snapshot and reverting to the snapshot inside QEMU. Let us start with taking snapshot. This operation is performed in the following way. Virtual CPU are stopped and the migration process is initiated. The migration stream is saved to one of virtual disks of the virtual machine. The problem here is that the process of saving RAM could take too much time, and all this time virtual machine would not be able to answer to any external requests. For example, with 1 TB VM on a very fast NVMe, the process could take 20 minutes or even several hours if we are saving to HDD and not to NVMe. One could say that the migration process working really good and we could achieve downtime with several seconds. But this would not work for the snapshot. The problem is that we initiate the migration and we will reach the state where we can save not the whole RAM but really small amount with acceptable downtime, not at the moment when the command to take snapshot is executed, but within several minutes or several hours or somewhere in the unpredictable future. But user making a snapshot expects that he would be able to revert to exactly the state of the command executed. Okay, what we can do? We should not just track dirty memory as on conventional migration process, but actively protect guest memory from a modification. In that case, once virtual CPU tries to modify the memory, the QEMU will receive a notification and save that memory pages before the page is actually modified by the guest. Also, we should have some background thread which will save the memory which is not touched by the guest. Okay, this is what actually commercial hypervisors are doing here. This is convention and well known. Why this is not implemented? This was not implemented so far. The problem is what we need to get some notification that the guest is actually modifying the page. That could be done in two ways. We could have a special KVM exit, or we should have standard Linux kernel notification mechanics. During discussions in the mailing list, the community comes to the agreement that we need to have a conventional notification way. So we should have write protect feature of user fault FD. This has been implemented only last year in the Linux kernel 5.7, and this gives a green light for a background snapshot feature. Also, there is yet another problem. There are several states of virtual disks, and only one disk state is readable, is writable at the time. Why this is a problem? The migration stream is saved to the state which should be read only once the snapshot is made. So we should be able to have two states readable in QCow2 driver. We have tried to solve this puzzle and they were unsuccessful. So they have to change some architecture and not use QEMU snapshot infrastructure. They come to a decision to use the migration infrastructure where the migration stream is saved to the disk by the external utility. Fortunately, this functionality is available through libvirt IO helper, and that is useful for us. They have implemented new migration capability, background snapshot, which setups the stuff. And once this capability is specified for the migration, we could just call virsave virtual machine and get virtual machine state saved externally. This also useful in terms of virtual machine testing. So far, so good. Okay, let us remind one thing. Dirty page tracking. As I have said, we are using user fault FD with write protect feature, and the guest, once the guest writes to the page, that page is saved to the migration stream. Once the page is saved, that page could be unprotected. Great. So far, so good. Let us switch to asynchronous revert to the snapshot. Right now, we should load the whole migration stream. And once the stream is loaded as a whole into the RAM, start the guest. The size of the stream increases the time once the first request in the guest could be served. So we need to implement something. But fortunately here, we should not change any code in the QEMU. There is a well-known feature, which is called postcopy migration. We start the guest with CPU state and device state loaded, and any missed guest memory page are served within the page fault for non-present page. But in this case, there is one problem. We need to be able to find the guest page by the guest physical address inside the migration stream. And that is not possible at the moment. Right now, the stream doesn't have any index. And if we will start to invent those index, we will have to introduce some incompatibility within QEMU protocols. We will have to have that index saved to the migration stream. Also, this index would not be so small, and that index should be able to keep several instances of each single page, as during the migration, those pages are sent several times. That is really awful. But we could do a little trick. We could convert the migration stream at the stage of saving it to HDD within the IO helper. In that case, we need to replace standard libvirt IO helper with some new tool. That new tool would be called QEMU snapshot tool. Okay, that snapshot tool should convert the migration stream at saving, and also that migration tool should be working as a server for post-copy migration. Thus, it should initiate the migration in pre-copy mode, transfer device state and maybe some memory. After that, it should switch the migration into the post-copy mode and actually start the guest. We do not need separate control channel for that. That is really good. We have a complexity of the migration stream storage kept in one place. Great. But not really great. There is still a problem. We should invent a format for the migration stream storage. The memory in the migration stream is sparse for two reasons. First of all, physical memory inside the guest is sparse. Some address ranges are not present. Also, the balloon driver inside the guest could kick out some pages from the guest, and that pages should not be stored. Okay. And also, we should store other part of a migration stream normally. The shiny side of this is that we should not invent something really new. There is a very good, well-known format which will fit for the purpose. We could reuse QCow2 in a little bit different way. We could store RAM in a data area of QCow2 as virtual disk, and we could save the migration stream without the memory to the same area as it was done before, just beyond the biggest physical guest physical address available. Okay? All the code for the implementation is available inside QEMU, and thus this code could be reused. The only thing we should need here is a proper start of a post-copy migration. But fortunately, post-copy migration could be start with a server specified in the conventional command sent through QMP channel. There is nothing very special and new here. All will work out of the box. We just need to provide the tool to serve as a server. That's it. Let us talk about the performance. We should measure two main things. We should measure the whole time of the snapshot operation, and we should measure the time when the guest is not accessible. For this purpose, I have used Linux VMs of different size, and for downtime I have measured not just simple ping, but the time to fetch some small file from HTTP server running inside virtual machine. As one could see, for synchronous snapshot the downtime is equal to the time of the whole operation, and for the background snapshot, the whole operation time is a little bit bigger. We have not done our homework for a snapshot tool yet to improve the performance of saving. But the downtime is really small, good, and shiny. It is several milliseconds and not tenth of seconds and so on. That's good. For revert to the snapshot, the situation is the same. Here we have spent more efforts for IO optimizing, but less efforts for downtime measuring, downtime optimizations. Unfortunately, the downtime is equals to half a second, which is really a big number. We have to improve it in the future. Okay, what is the current state of the project? Right now, user fault FD with write protect, as I have mentioned, is measured into Linux kernel 5.7. Background snapshot feature is merged into QEMU 6.0. And QEMU snapshot tool RFC has been sent in the May of this year. We have to improve this stuff further. What problems do we have? There are several problems. First of all, the guest is not working really good just after revert to the snapshot. There is no memory, and we have to solve this puzzle. First, we can track what memory is accessed after the snapshot is taken. We are good at that. Once we have made the snapshot, we are monitoring which memory pages are changed in the guest in the background snapshot operation. That is not enough. We should also start tracking accessed pages. This can be done in through user fault FD, but that would be slow. I think that we could have a bitmap of accessed pages inside the guest. That information is available in EPT or RVI inside the processor, and we will have to fetch it to really calculate the working set of the guest after the snapshot has been taken. Okay, and there is another problem. Unfortunately, user fault FD is single-threaded. If virtual CPU faces write protected page or faces non-present page, it stuck, and until that page fault is not satisfied inside QEMU. Unfortunately, only one thread at the moment could process this operation. We can either make user fault FD multi-threaded, which is quite complex, or at a first attempt create several user fault FDs for pieces of physical address spaces of the guest. At least we should think on that and make some improvements here. That is what we are actively working right now. So this work should make the QEMU working in the same way as commercial hypervisors. That is all that I would like to talk today. Thank you very much for your attention. If you have some questions, I would be happy to answer to them. Thank you again.